Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Metals Industry Research and Development Center. And today, we are gathered for the inauguration and launching of the Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory, or the AMERIAL.
We are enjoined by DOST Secretary Honorable Fortunato T. De La Peña, MIRDC Executive Director Engineer Robert O. Dizon, Fischer'd Executive Director Dr. Enrico Siparingit, and MRSP President Engineer Marichelle M. Tugangco for the ribbon cutting and unveiling of the AMERIAL marker.
The marker reads, Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory, established to support the technological advancement, workforce improvement, and competitiveness of the metals and engineering industries. Inaugurated the 16th day of June 2021 by Honorable Fortunato T. De La Peña, Dr. Rowena Cristina L. Guevara, Dr. Enrico C. Paringit, Engineer Robert O. Dizon, and Engineer Marichelle M. Tiogangco.
Again, good morning, everyone. I hope everyone is safe and in good health. I am Maybelline D. Rivera.
And I am Von Comedia.
From the Metals Industry Research and Development Center, and we will be your host for today's activity.
We are very thankful to everyone for making themselves available during this special event. We can also be watched from the MIRDC Facebook page, MIRDC YouTube channel, and the DOST Philippines Facebook page. And we are now in the second part of our program. To formally start, we would like to request everyone to please rise for the opening prayer. Standing for the national anthem.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Ayang mag-ibig, Diyos na sinahanan, alam ng puso, sa dikit mo'y buhay.
So now, pwede na po maupo. Now to acknowledge the presence of our dear guest and to give his opening remarks, please welcome our Deputy Executive Director for Technical Services and 2021 MNU Week Chair, Engineer Jonathan Q. Puerto.
To DOST Secretary Fortunato T. De La Peña, to DOST Undersecretary for R&D, Rowena Cristina L. Guevara, to DOST Fisher Director Enrico C. Paringit, to MIRDC Executive Director and Project Leader of the Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory, Robert O. Dison. To the President of the Mechatronics Robotics Society of the Philippines, Engineer Maricel M. Chuganco. To the former President of MRSP, Ariel Duran. To Mr. Eric Soliman, President of HITECH. My colleagues in government service, to our participants and viewers, a pleasant day to all. Welcome to AMERIAL. The celebration of this year's Metals and Engineering Week is very momentous and timely to the metals and engineering, as we are providing two new advanced facilities for the industry. Last Monday, we inaugurated the Advanced Manufacturing Center, or AMSEN, and it was a success. Today, we are going to inaugurate the Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory. This facility, which we offer to the industry, will serve as a training and technology hub that will strengthen the automation, mechatronics, and robotics technology skills and competencies of the Filipino workforce in the manufacturing industry. The AMERIAL will also pave the way to jumpstart the Philippines' competitiveness as the world transitions towards Industry 4.0. I can already see in the future what the AMERIAL can contribute to the advancement of science and technology of our country. So we invite everyone to join us as we open the AMERIAL facility. Today's program will be filled with significant activities. We prepared a video to show and encourage our audience and viewers to engage in the fields of mechatronics, robotics, and industrial automation. Director Dison, the project leader of AMERIAL, will give us the overview and services. We'll also take you on a tour of the facility and present a demo of the state-of-the-art smart factory and the six-axis collaborative robot. As we open this facility today, at a time when we are faced with the challenges of having to cope up with the drastic change in the way business operates, as discussed during yesterday's virtual talakayan with the metals and engineering industry, in order to be competitive in their businesses, there's a need to mechanize or automate. And this is where AMERIAL is going to come in. The capabilities of the AMERIAL are here. During these very trying times when our workers have to learn new skills, we have a facility that offers training and consultancy services to the MSMEs. Friends in the industry and the academe, today is the day when we finally show you that we have a place to go for your requirements involving technologies that will surely help build better capabilities for production and enhance skills needed as we shift towards Industry 4.0. I would like also to take this opportunity to invite everyone to participate in our activities afternoon. We will have two webinars. First is the PLC, Introduction to the Program Logic Control. And second is the Introduction to Automation Studio. Again, welcome to the AMERIAL. Let's have a great and inspiring morning together. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Engineer Perto, for your opening remarks. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to give us an inspiring message, may we call on Dr. Enrico C. Paringit, Executive Director of PSHERD.
A pleasant morning to all our partners in advancing metals and engineering industries in the Philippines. Of course, we'd like to send special greetings to our DOST officials, led, of course, by our very inspiring Secretary, Fortunato T. de la Peña, our Undersecretary for Research and Development, Dr. Rowena Cristina L. Guevara, our host for today's event, the Executive Director of the Metals Industry Research and Development Center, Director Robert O. Dison, the Mechatronics and Robotics Society of the Philippines, National President, Engineer Maricel M. Teoganco, the MIRDC Deputy Executive Director for Technical Services, Engineer Jonathan Q. Puerto, the MIRDC Deputy Executive Director for R&D, Dr. Agustin M. Podolik, High-Tech Power Incorporated President, Engineer Eric Jude S. Soliman, the APA Academia General Manager, Dave Molina, the DOST Region 1 Regional Director, Dr. Arman Q. Ganal, and all of the engineers, guests, and colleagues present in today's event. On behalf of the DOST Philippine Council for Industry, Energy, and Emerging Technology Research and Development, we congratulate the DOST Metals Industry Research and Development Center for successfully inaugurating and launching the Philippines' first and so far only automation laboratory for micro, small, and medium enterprises, the Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory. We commend the teams behind AMERIAL for achieving this milestone in being able to render high-quality services for the Filipino SMEs and help them digitize and automate their processes so that they can adapt to the emerging transition in the manufacturing to Industry 4.0. As the monitoring agency of AMERIAL, DOST-STII shared sees AMERIAL as another win for the country's MSMEs and the metals in engineering sector as it creates and armors a pool of skilled and highly qualified workforce to become accredited training and development facility in industrial automation. As your leading partner in enabling innovations, we at Pissured will remain committed to increasing the country's industry productivity. As your attendance in today's event implies that you are all for the growth of the metals and engineering sector and the manufacturing industry, I bring with me some good news that you can partner with us to bolster the sectors in the spotlight today. We recently announced the call for proposals and applications for the DOST Shared Capability Development Program, which provides grants for human resource and infrastructure development. You can collaborate with us to establish laboratories and facilities like the AMERIAL through our Infrastructure Development Program. IDP pushes for the establishment or upgrading of research laboratories by providing financial support to purchase laboratory equipment, highly specialized computer software, and small grants for researchers within the institution. Here are some of the facilities that were established through IDP. We have the AMCERAM, or the Additive Manufacturing Center for Industrial Ceramics, at Adamson University. We also supported the Additive Manufacturing Research Laboratory, or AMREL, at the Bataan Peninsula State University, and the Advanced Computational Research Center for Modeling and Simulation, which is the first computational science laboratory at the University of San Carlos in the Visayas. We also helped set up the proposed TUP College of Engineering Sensors and Mechatronics Laboratory, which aims to actually train instructors and students on mechatronics. And the facility will serve as a training center for engineering programs of PUP branches and campuses and for other state universities and colleges. To continuously promote and improve the culture of research at the Mindanao State University, we also supported the establishment of the Intelligent Systems Laboratory that will facilitate faculty research focusing on the thrust areas of the university and other stakeholders. So far, the Infrastructure Development Program of APSHIRD has helped set up and upgrade 23 laboratories all over the country, amounting to investments of about 125 million. We are hoping that soon your institution will be included in our roster of institutions that were supported through the IDP. We are also giving assistance to individuals seeking to upgrade their skills in research through our human resource development program. You can actually choose from one of the programs flashed on screen. We have the Visiting Experts Program, the Research Attachment, the Laboratory and Research Equipment Grant, the Presentation of Scientific Outputs in Conferences, Symposia, and Fora, and Seminars. You can also have your publication supported in scientific or research papers or technical journals. You can be given support as researchers for the development of new skills and knowledge aligned with, of course, our priorities in key sectors through our research on industry, energy, and emerging technologies, opening opportunities for learning or retool. And we also provide assistance to current projects being supported by Fisher to attain graduate scholarships for the completion of their graduate degrees while gaining research experience in the said project. This is called providing research opportunities and support for project-based personnel and researchers, or PROSPER. And lastly, we also have our Balik Saliksik program, which opens our doors to support new PhD graduate returnees who have just obtained their PhD elsewhere. We encourage everyone here today to whose goal is to make change in the metals and engineering industry by submitting their proposals or applications through our DPMIS. Grab this opportunity and turn your ideas into reality. All the information about our capacity development program or CAPTEP program can be accessed at the Fisher website. So please take note of the link indicated in the slide. Going back to today's celebration, DOST Fisher sends its warmest congratulations for AMERIAL team for establishing this laboratory that will truly fast-track the growth and progress of Filipino MSMEs and the metals and engineering sector. DOST takes pride in this winning moment for MIRDC. With a common goal of uplifting the lives of Filipinos, we envision AMERIAL as a powerful amplifier of science and technology for maximum economic and social benefits to the Filipinos whom we all committed to serve. With the shared efforts and common purpose, we can accelerate the future of Philippine innovation and bring a new dimension to innovations that truly works for the people. Thank you very much. Mabuhay tayong lahat.
Thank you po, Dr. Paringit. So to give us another inspiring message, let's give the floor to the National President of the MRSP, Engineer Marichelle M. Tiugangco.
First and foremost, I would like to greet each and everyone a pleasant good morning. I know that this is a very exciting event for MIRDC, DOST, and also for MRSP. So we are very proud and also very honored that our officers in MRSP have collaborated with MIRDC, with the leadership of our former president, Engineer Franklin Quiachon, and also spearheaded by Director Dison. So we are very excited in the university as well in the industry that this laboratory will now be open, and soon our country will benefit from it. So once again, thank you very much and good morning.
Thank you very much, Engineer Tiugangco, for your inspiring message. And now, to introduce our keynote speaker, may we call on Engineer Rodnell O. Tamayo, Chief of MIRDC's Prototyping Division.
Good morning, everyone. Our keynote speaker is a very well-known engineer and started his career in the late 60s. A passionate learner, he rose to become a full professor in 1988. He served the University of the Philippines, his alma mater, for more than 40 years. He occupied various positions whose roles and responsibilities he attended to with passion and sincere dedication. He became the chairman of the Department of Industrial Engineering and Operations Research, assistant to the executive director of the National Engineering Center, director of the Institute for Small-Scale Industries and System Vice President for Planning and Development, to name a few. At the Department of Science and Technology, he became director. At the DOST Technology Application and Promotions Institute. Later on, he served as Undersecretary for Scientific and Technical Services, after which he retired in 2014. The government under President Duterte appointed him DOST Secretary in 2016. His achievements are remarkable. He is a recipient of several awards from different offices. More importantly, he is known for his positive and motivational attitude towards others. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming the man who truly inspires us all, our very hardworking, very supportive DOST Secretary Fortunato T. De La Peña on stage for his keynote message.
Magandang umaga sa ating lahat. I think I will have some, slides to share with you to guide me in my message today. First of all, allow me to greet our co-workers here, Dr. Eric Paringit, the Executive Director of Fisher, of course, Executive Director Bob Dison of MIRDC, the Deputy Director who spoke earlier, si Jonathan Puerto, our guest from the MRSP, si former President Ariel Duran, and of course, the current President, si Maricel Teoganco. At sa ating lahat dito, nagagalak ako na nandito uli ako sa MIRDC. I was here on Monday to inaugurate our Advanced Manufacturing Center, AMSEN. You know, AMSEN, very easy to remember what it means, you know. But AMERIAL, I am proud to say that I have already memorized it as of today. The Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory. Okay, so this has been in the making for quite some time, and MRSP has really played a key role in setting up the AMERIAL facilities or laboratory. And before I just show here, allow me to recall a few things that have been stuck in my mind regarding AMERIAL. One of them was our visit to the Philippine Navy in Cavite. That was mga 1.5 2019 pa yun, ano? Okay, when we visited the Buhawi project of MIRDC and MRSP, and it really is a demonstration of how our local talents, you know, and expertise can do something that is, shall we say, globally comparable. Okay. In the same way that I have seen many possible applications of advanced or additive manufacturing in the health sector, I also think that there could be a lot of applications in the medical field as far as AMERIAL is concerned. Now, we have seen, for example, although I think we have not assisted them, I'm not sure, but the Lisa robot of UST is an example of robotics being used in the medical field or area. And long before, of course, we have already learned that robotics is already heavily applied in the operating rooms of hospitals, okay? And I was discussing with Director Eric earlier, and he said when we go into our project on oxygen concentrators, maybe there can also be some applications of AMERIAL there. And so there are many applications in the manufacture of equipment and machineries. Definitely, there's a lot of automation involved in smart agriculture. I still remember that visit to a farm that specializes on pigmented rice, which was led by graduates of Philippine Science High School, yung namamahala nung farm na yon, and they have applied the robotics, ano, yung kanilang pagtatanggal ng mga weeds, ano, in their plots were already assisted by robots. And of course, there are maybe things that we should look in the public sector that can be assisted by robots. No? Natatawa si Dr. Eric. Sa public sector, oo. But let me go through what I have prepared here with regards to the agenda for our AMERIAL. So, okay, so we are actually following quite religiously the Harmonized National Research and Development Agenda. This was formulated at the beginning of the term of this present administration and in 2016 and was approved by NEDA in 2017. So it runs until 2022 for a period of 6 years. Next slide, please. Now, the Harmonized National Research and Development Agenda actually covers different sectors. So meron tayo sa agriculture, meron tayo sa health, meron tayo sa industry and energy, meron sa basic sciences, meron sa disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation. But more recently, I think we have seen how science and technology have played a key role in addressing many problems during the pandemic, you know, from development of our own PCR test, you know, the Gen Amplify, to the development of the disease model that is being used by the IATF, to the various natural products that are being tried for their effect on COVID-19, like those that have already been approved as drugs or supplements for other diseases like Lagundi and BCO and even Tawa-Tawa for dengue. They are being tested now for use in COVID-19. And of course, our participation in the vaccine trials, whether they are with WHO or whether with our bilateral partners. And there are also many areas in, as I mentioned already, in biomedical devices where we have played an important role. So here, I just wanted to show the things that can be mentioned as far as the role of our science and technology has played in the case of the pandemic. Next slide, please. So our main program here in AMERIAL has the program titled Transforming the Philippine MSMEs Through Industry 4.0 Technologies. And I think it has already been said very well articulated by Secretary of Finance Dominguez III, when he spoke as our keynote speaker last Monday, emphasizing the importance of digitalization and technical innovations in moving forward. And we heard, of course, and we were very delighted to hear his very strong support now for technology and for innovations as the way to move forward. It is very important to note that the chair of the cabinet cluster on economic development is with us. Next slide, please. Well, maiksi lang pala yung aking mga slides. But really, the one of the important services that we can play here is our role in assisting our MSMEs. We have existing programs like the Small Enterprise Technology Upgrading Program, where we can already promote some of the MSMEs. You know, we have already assisted them by way of acquiring new hardware, new software to upgrade their productivity and capability to produce different kinds of products. But now we can even move further, okay, elevating them to the level of Industry 4.0, where we use cyber and automation technologies to improve their operations. And again, It's not only in the private sector, of course, in the industry sector, but also in the public sector where we can look for different ways to improve services through industrial automation. Maybe not all of you know that I have been advisor of the Philippine Instrumentation Society since 1991. Okay, and of course, yung mga kasabay ko doong mga naging presidente, mga nagkamatay na, no? Yung iba. So, kaya siguro hindi na ako hinihinga ng advice ngayon. I really appreciate the work, you know, yung sa instrumentation, sa robotics, sa mechanization. At that has been one of the things I really enjoyed offering when I was director of the Institute for Small Scale Industries in UP for 10 years. We had an automation program there, and it really, I think, was a big contribution to our MSME. So again, as I pose a challenge to the partners of AMSEN yesterday during the signing of the various MOUs, I would like the various partners of AMERIAL, MIRDC through AMERIAL, to also think of their own unique contributions, whether it is a product, a technology, a program, or a research work that can really demonstrate the usefulness and the important role of advanced mechatronics, robotics, and industrial automation in our goal of advancing our industries to be competitive and to be world-class. Marami pong salamat.
Thank you very much, Secretary Fortunato de la Peña, for that wonderful keynote message. Your words will keep the AMERIAL pushing forward towards more challenges to come in the future.
Thank you po, Secretary. And now, to give us a general idea of what the AMERIAL is all about, we'll be playing the program's promotional video.
Technologies keep changing the way we do things. Mechatronics. Robotics. Industrial automation. We have all these in the AMERIAL. What is the AMERIAL all about? We are presently implementing the establishment of the Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory, or the AMERIAL, which will be a training and research and development hub for mechatronics, robotics, and industrial automation for the academe and the industry, where we will conduct activities to support MSMEs in terms of technological advancement, improvement of workforce, and enhancement of competitiveness, to help transform MSMEs to be ready for Industry 4.0. Housed in the compound of the DOST Metals Industry Research and Development Center in Bicutan, Taguig City, the AMERIAL is found at the Titanium Building. Let us take a closer look at the AMERIAL. Now in the third and final year of the project, AMERIAL is almost complete. In the lab, we have the state-of-the-art smart factory learning system, six-axis collaborative robot, and mechatronics training kit for pneumatics, hydraulics, PLC, and HMI programming. The 8-station smart factory learning system. Each station features a smart sensor or component such as vacuum, ultrasonic, photo eye, stack light, electrical current, and analog pressure sensors. The smart factory learning system connects physical systems, operational information, and human assets. It controls actions such as manufacturing, maintenance, inventory, and supply chain operators. The six-axis collaborative robot, mechatronics training kit for pneumatics, hydraulics, PLC, and HMI all complement the smart factory robot. AMERIAL also has a virtual laboratory system to train future engineers and technicians through simulations that depicts the real-life application of actual mechatronics and automation technologies. The AMERIAL also serves MSMEs in the region. We provide consultancy services and assess how MSMEs can stay productive and competitive in the era of Industry 4.0.
We are engaged in production of furniture made of wood and bamboo. Before the maintenance cost of our equipment is high as well as the power consumption. Now, through the help of AMERIAL, we already established the right and stable facility to use in order to protect our equipment and its components.
AMERIAL also engages in R&D. We have R&D activities in the areas of agriculture, medicine, and food processing. With all these great things going with the AMERIAL, we encourage organizations across various industries. Whether you are in an agricultural community or in the academe or the industry sector or in government service, to partner with us.
A knowledge and technology hub in Asia Pacific region. This is the vision of Kalinga State University, or KSU. While the strategy of the College of Engineering and Information Technology of this university is to determine the needs of the industries, agriculture sectors, and other clients so we can offer solutions through research and extension. We are fortunate to have AMERIAL, a joint DOST-KSU endeavor of identifying the concerns of our clients and offering solutions. Right now, we are assembling a motor control for a client that our AMERIAL team visited. Our industries and agricultural entrepreneurs need support in order for them to thrive and flourish. It is indeed so nice to see AMERIAL around, ready to offer a helping hand. Thank you.
Let us take advantage of new technologies in the fields of mechatronics, robotics, and industrial automation to make a stronger impact, to increase productivity, to use materials more efficiently, to improve product quality, to prioritize safety, and to reduce lead times.
The Mechatronics and Robotics Society of the Philippines is honored to partner with DOST-MIRDC in the AMERIAL project. We advocate for the research and development, innovation, and the sharing of expertise, information, and experience, because we believe that these are the best strategies that will advance the field of mechatronics and robotics in the country. Through the AMERIAL, we will build the necessary capabilities to shape our manpower, our industries, and the Philippines in general. Together, we will be ready and we will be competitive.
Let us take this journey towards Industry 4.0. See it all happen here at the AMERIAL.
And for us to better understand the service offerings of the AMERIAL, may we call on our very own Executive Director of MIRDC, and project leader of AMERIAL himself, Engineer Robert O. Dizon.
Fortunato de la Peña, Yusek Guevara and Yusek Sancho Maborang, Director Eric Maringit, Director Arman Ganal of Region 1, President of the MRSP, Marcel Toanco, and Past President Ariel Duran, Hi-Tech President Eric Soliman, my fellow MIRDC workers, and also from the STII. Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. May I share with you an overview and the services of AMERIAL? But before that, let me give you a brief history. Sec boy, pasensya na po kayo. Alam ko sawang-sawa na kayo sa Industry 4.0, but AMERIAL really is anchored on I4.0. If you Google I4.0, you will see that the Germans coined the term way back in 2011. I heard about I4.0 the first time in 2015 during an MRSP convention. And during that convention, MRSP suggested that MIRDC should lead the country in acquiring this technology, learn it, and share with everyone what I4.0 is all about. So in 2016, we crafted the AMEROB project proposal. AMEROB is Advanced Mechatronics and Robotics. That's what we call, how we used to call AMERIAL back then. So we submitted the proposal to be shared, but there were a lot of unknowns. Of course, we were quite ignorant of I4.0 back then. So everything really is unknown. We don't know what equipment to procure, to acquire. We don't know what to use them for. We don't know what trainings or training programs to conduct. So everything was unknown. Fortunately, si past Fisher Director, si Dr. C.P. David, gave us an opportunity to do some benchmarking. So in January of 2017, we had a study mission. We visited MIRDC Taiwan and the Thai German Institute in Thailand. We saw there their facility on smart manufacturing training. We also visited Festo and SMC Pneumatics, the two leading providers of smart manufacturing learning systems. Oops. But from that benchmarking, so medyo nabawasan na yung unknown. We were able to identify what equipment to procure, or what at least the specs of the equipment that we want to acquire. But still, we didn't know what to use them for, what R&D we will be conducting, what trainings we will be developing. So we had a problem with Fishard. Actually, it was a chicken and egg situation. They want us to be able to identify what we are going to do with the equipment if we procure them. But for us, we need to have the equipment first. So we will be able, we have to learn the equipment, how to use the equipment for us to be able to identify what to use them for. So walang nangyari nung 2017. Because yun nga, we were in a chicken and egg situation. In March 2018, I was able to attend an APO, Asian Productivity Organization study mission on I4.0 in Japan. That was when I learned, or that was an eye-opening experience for me, that I4.0 is not really about acquiring the latest and the most sophisticated technologies. I4.0 is getting there. I4.0 is about productivity. It's about improving our processes, improving quality, reducing waste. It's not necessarily using the most sophisticated equipment out there for your processes, for your manufacturing processes. It is about using the right, the appropriate equipment or the most appropriate technology. And in Japan, I was also surprised that I was expecting that many companies in Japan have already embraced I4.0 and are applying it. But no, I learned that most MSMEs in Japan are still in I2.0 stage. And they have programs there to upgrade these firms from I2.0 to I3.0, not necessarily directly to I4.0. So to get to I4.0, you have to pass I1.0, 2.0, 3.0. It's not instantly going to be I4.0. Anyway, in June of 2018, that was 3 years ago, in the same period ng M&D Week, I presented a sort of eco-seminar during the M&E conference. What I learned from the APO study mission. Fortunately, Yusek Guevara was there. She attended. And after my presentation, she told me, "Bob, MIRDC should be doing yung mga sinabi mo na ginagawa sa Japan." Sabi ko, "Ma'am, hindi na-approve yung project proposal natin sa PSIRD eh. Eh kasi nga, mali yung proposal niyo. So this is what you should do. Instead of just a project, yung AMERIAL project, think of a program." So doon na po nanganak or pinanganak yung program na transforming Philippine MSMEs through I4.0 technology. Yun, thank you talaga kay Yusek Kev galing yun. So it's not just about establishing a facility, it's about using technology to help the MSMEs upgrade their operations para ma-transform sila if they are still in I1.0, maging I2.0. If they are in 2.0, maging 3.0 and so on. So, finally, in December of that year, after revising the proposal and yun na nga, yung mga discussions with, not just with Yusek Geb, but with Yusek, Brenda, and the regions, yun, na-approve na yung AMERIAL project. Of course, kasama dyan yung mga targets, deliverables, yung mga activities that we have to do in the regions. The original date, target date of the AMERIAL launching was last year, during the M&E Week last year. Siyempre, wala tayong celebration last year. Hindi rin dumating yung mga equipment natin on time. Finally, we are launching it today or na-launch na nga natin. And sabi nga doon sa marker natin, AMERIAL is established to support the technological advancement, workforce improvement, and competitiveness of the metals and engineering industries. For the objectives, ayan po yung project objectives ng AMERIAL, to acquire technologies, conduct research, develop training curriculum, and provide the trainings. So today, check na po ang number one. The others, ongoing. The project will be up to December of this year. So ongoing pa po yung other tasks natin. Now, I won't be showing or presenting yung mga facility, yung mga equipment natin in this facility. Kasi nakita nyo na kanina yan sa promotional video and mamaya, we will have a demonstration. So, let me share with you how you can avail of the services or what services are here in AMERIAL and how you can avail of them. Essentially, we have three major services. R&D, training, and consultancy. So R&D po is yung pwedeng internal R&D namin or the industry or academe pwede mag-partner sa with us. They can contract us for contract research or they can do R&D here. So yun po yung facility sharing. Everybody is open to use the facility for their R&D needs. Then we also have training. We were supposed to have a MOA signing with TESDA for the curriculum development of the higher levels of competencies in mechatronics and robotics. Pero hindi pa po nag-materialize yung MOA signing namin. But it's in the pipeline. Right now, we are providing basic trainings on basic automation. Pero yung mga advanced po, under development pa po ang curriculum. Consultancy, that's what we have been doing since the start. We are going around the country, visiting firms, assessing, observing their operation, and evaluating if there are potential automation projects that can be applied in their operation that can improve their productivity, their product quality, and reduce waste. And these services, hindi na po ito bago sa MIRDC. We are not establishing a new section or a new group, new unit for these services. They are embedded or integrated to our existing sections. Meron po tayong equipment prototyping section, they will handle the R&D of AMERIAL. We have the industrial training section, ITS, to handle the training services of AMERIAL. Then we have the TABADS, the technology advisory and business development section, to handle consultancy. And we also have, AMERIAL is sort of a matrix structure. We have three basic topics here. First is the smart factory or I 4.0. We have industrial automation, which is I 3.0, and mechatronics and robotics. Let me tell you that the assignments of the people here is a bit arbitrary because all of these people have been trained on everything. So yung assignments nila dyan is for accountability purposes only, but any one of them can do other things. But if you want to avail of our services, you have to just approach these two, si Mary Rose Arellano and Maybelline Rivera. That's how we will conduct business with you. Approach these two. Sila na po ang bahala, whatever it is that you require of AMERIAL. At this point, I would like to thank DBM. Sir, nung Monday, I said na na-approve yung ng DBM yung additional position. We requested for additional permanent position from DBM. So nag-approve po sila ng 3 for AMSEN and 3 permanent position for AMERIAL. So yung mga contractual dito, yan, matuwa kayo kasi there are now available permanent positions for you. So yun po, also, one major announcement. Our services will be offered free of charge up to December of this year, until the end of the project. Next year po, may bayad na. So what are you waiting for? Come in, we're open. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much. Engineer Dazon for that informative overview on what AMERIAL will be offering the public. So you heard that, guys. Maraming services na inoopen ng AMERIAL and free of charge hanggang December. So now to see what's actually inside the AMERIAL, we will be having a tour inside the laboratory, and may we invite Director Dazon to accompany our dear guests towards the different rooms inside the facility.
Looking in the hydraulics training equipment. So if you want to learn more about hydraulics and how to troubleshoot and install its accompanying components, you can learn it here in AMERIAL and using this particular equipment. So now we have Ms. Michelle Navarro demonstrating to our dear guests the capabilities of that equipment. And now they are looking into the HMI and PLC SCADA training equipment. Ms. Michelle Navarro also demonstrates the capabilities of the training equipment to our dear guests. So if you want to learn more about PLC programming and SCADA software programming, you can also learn it here in AMERIAL using this equipment. And now, our dear guest is heading towards the centerpiece of the AMERIAL, the Smart Factory 4.0 training equipment. So this training equipment features 8 mechatronics stations. Station 1, pick and place feeding. Station 2, gauging. The third station is about orientation processing. The fourth station is sorting and buffering. The fifth station is servo robotic assembly. The sixth station is in torque assembly. Station 7 is about inventory storage. And station 8 is about hydraulic press. The whole training equipment has also a robot integrated into the system to facilitate the integration of robotics to manufacturing capabilities of the smart factory. So if you want to learn more about the actual manufacturing process, actual automation processes in the industry, you can learn it here in AMERIAL through our Smart Factory 4.0 training equipment. Dear guests are heading towards our research and development room wherein we conduct our various research and development activities. So during the 3-year duration of the Project AMERIAL, we have developed various prototypes in medicine, agriculture, and among others. So they're looking in our prototype of a dialysis machine, a localized dialysis machine. That is being headed by Mr. Robin Costale and Mr. Kim Orquilla. And we also developed an adult ventilator from the infant ventilator Austrian prototype. So currently the Austrian 2 ventilator for adults is being deployed in PGH for its approved clinical trials. And we also developed an automated irrigation controller that is now currently being tested in a organic produce farm in Maihai, Laguna. So if you want to collaborate with AMERIAL and conduct research and development, you can contact us and let's see what we can work on. Tison demonstrates the capabilities of the Austrian 2 prototype that is currently being tested in the Philippine General Hospital or PGH. And now, our dear guest is heading towards our virtual laboratory room. So we are featuring the automation studio software for our virtual laboratory room. So it features system design and engineering, system validation and simulation, testing and commissioning, project documentation, technical machine-oriented training, maintenance and diagnostics, and you can do also technical publication in our software.
Our dear guests and viewers enjoyed the tour inside the facility. Let us now move on to another part of the program. Throughout the establishment of the AMERIAL, we had the opportunity to work with wonderful people that support the advancement of mechatronics and industrial automation as they work in their respective career.
And now let us hear from Mr. Dave V. Molina, General Manager of Academia.
Good day, everyone. I'm Dave Molina, and I am the co-founder and acting general manager of Academia. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate DOST-MIRDC for the successful launch and inauguration of the Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory, or in short, the AMERIAL. This effort, I believe, will be a big step in dramatically making technology-based processes more available and accessible to many industries here in our country. With them, we can expect the Philippines with a more skilled and highly qualified workforce that will spearhead our country's growth and prosperity as we go through the Industry 4.0. Again, congratulations, DOST-MIRDC. More power to you, and I hope and pray that AMERIAL will soon become the Philippines' premier training and development facility when it comes to industrial automation.
So thank you, Mr. Dave Molina. Now let's hear another message from the Regional Director of DOST Region 1, Dr. Armando Q. Ganal.
Our DOST Secretary, Professor Fortunato T. De La Peña, Undersecretary for Research and Development, Dr. Rowena Cristina.
Dapat daw isoli yung luma. Hindi ko na makita.
Undersecretary for Regional Operations, Engineer Sancho Mabora. Undersecretary for S&T Services, Dr. Rene Solidum, other top DOST officials, MIRDC Executive Director Robert Dizon, directors of attached agencies, regional directors, provincial S&T directors, the Project AMERIAL team, officials from SUCs and the HEIs, other colleagues, good morning. The realization of institutionalizing the advanced mechatronics, robotics, and industrial automation laboratory in the regions will be a very big support for the metals and engineering industry towards Industry 4.0. Thanks to the Metals Industry Research and Development Center, with support from our DOST top management for initiating this very laudable project to come to the regions, that we have already included process automation as part of the assessment for technology needs of our micro, small, and medium enterprises. Even before this official project launching, the Project AMERIAL team has already gone around the regions, visited the setup assisted firms, and evaluated how automation can be included in their production process. Some of our assisted firms in Region 1 have appreciated this intervention. It made us realize that it is about time to go into automation. With the establishment of the Metals and Engineering Innovation Center, automation will be one of the technical services. In fact, one of our SOOCs in the region has already formed its local AMERIAL team and will be teaming up with MIRDC for faster adoption of automation in the region. As in other innovation centers, the MEIC will be into R&D on new equipment designs, improvement of existing ones, fabrication of equipment that are needed for agri-mechanization and other industries, a knowledge hub for academic engagements and technical and consultancy services. We will be the AMERIAL team for the region. In behalf of DOST Region 1, I congratulate you for this activity. As I always remind everyone, stay safe and healthy. Let us not allow this dreaded disease to come and affect us, especially our friends and families. Good day to one and all.
Director Ganal. And lastly, let us hear from the President of the Hi-Tech Power Incorporated, Engineer Eric Jude S. Soliman.
Good morning, everyone. I am Pepper.
And I am Now. And we are Hi-Tech Power's intelligent robots.
Allow us to greet first our distinguished guests, Honorable Fortunato T. de la Peña, Secretary of the Department of Science and Technology,
Dr. Rowena Cristina L. Guevara, Undersecretary for Research and Development, Department of Science and Technology,
Engineer Robert O'Deason, Executive Director of Metals Industry Research and Development Center, MIRDC,
Dr. Enrico C. Paranyit, Executive Director of Philippine Council for Industry, Energy, and Emerging Technology Research and Development,
Engineer Maricel M. Tiagongco, National President of the Mechatronics and Robotics Society of the Philippines.
And to all other guests and officials, have a good day.
Together with Engineer Eric Jude Soliman and the whole Hi-Tech Power family,
we would like to congratulate MIRDC for the inauguration and launching of the Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory, AMERIAL. This laboratory is the first of its kind in the country, a complete setup of a fully operational mechatronics, robotics, and industrial automation laboratory that supports workforce improvement and technological innovations. This is a vital step of MIRDC to promote development in manufacturing and technology-based processes, and enhancement of workforce skills through a premier training and development facility, aligned to the requirements of Industry 4.0. It is also important to note that this facility will be of great help for research and development efforts of our engineers, technicians, and scientists.
Our company has been privileged to be part of this endeavor, and we would like to thank MIRDC for trusting us as your partner. Hi-Tech Power has always been vigorous in promoting technology innovations both in the industry and academe. Industry 4.0 has been the core of discussions and presentation to different institutions and organizations. And today, one of our dream is coming to life: the Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory.
We continuously support your endeavors towards technological advancements and innovations. Our company is always open for MIRDC and DOST, and we are extending our hands in whatever way that we could be of help to you and to the country. We also urge MIRDC to pursue international certification, particularly the certification from the Smart Automation Certification Alliance or SACA, which empowers its mission to develop occupational skills standards, promote careers, train teachers, and certify individuals in the main function of smart automation technologies.
In fact, we are encouraging AMERIAL and MRSP to have an office at our virtual building, the HPI Cyber Hub, a global space for technology innovation, creativity, and learning. It is virtual building, where you can conduct meeting, present videos, and keep your files and documents all in the cloud. This cyber hub will house our office and training facility. Aside from this, it will be open to external organizations looking for a unique and high online platform for your conferences, meetings, and others. It has an auditorium, expo hall, networking lounge, and meeting rooms. We invite you to connect with us for other details of the HPI Cyber Hub.
Again, we would like to congratulate everyone for a successful project, and we only hope for the best for your institution and for the country in general. This is indeed a timely progress for the Philippines to boost areas in training and research aligned with the advancement in industrial technology, the Industry 4.0. We commend the efforts of all officials and staff of MIRDC through the leadership of Director Deason. We are looking forward to the completion of the full-blown smart factory enterprise to further maximize its capabilities.
May we continue to strive to impart new and powerful ideas to our people, in our efforts to solve job skills mismatch in the industry. In this way, we can contribute to uplifting the lives of Filipino families towards a harmonious society.
Suleiman, and to all our other guests for extending their warm regards towards the AMERIAL.
Since we are also graced by our very supportive Undersecretary for Research and Development and Undersecretary for Regional Operations, we would also like to hear a few words from them. May we start with you, Sec. Rowena Cristina Guevara.
Department of Science and Technology Secretary Fortunato T. De La Peña, DOST Regional Operations Undersecretary Sancho Maboran, DOST Philippine Council for Industry, Energy and Emerging Technology Research and Development Executive Director Dr. Enrico C. Pariñe, DOST Metals Industry Research and Development Center led by its Executive Director Robert Deason, DOST-I Regional Director, Armand Ganal, the Mechatronics and Robotics Society of the Philippines, or MRSP, led by Engineer Maricel M. Teoganco, guests from industry, fellow government employees, a pleasant morning to all of you. The start of the third industrial revolution has brought forth advancements in process automation enjoyed by the manufacturing sector. As we advance to the fourth industrial revolution, the Department of Science and Technology encourages programs that further promote the use of new technologies. Technologies that will help our nation be at par with the current trends of globalization and advanced manufacturing. These new technologies offer another pathway towards economic development. I'm glad that the country now has these technologies available for our local industry to take advantage of. Through the Advanced Mechatronics Robotics Industrial Automation Laboratory, or AMERIAL, the manufacturing sector, especially the micro, small, and medium enterprises, will greatly benefit from this improved quality, high productivity, cost savings, and waste reduction, among others. I'm also pleased that AMERIAL has structured its operation to undertake three major activities, which are research and development, human resource development, and business consultancy. Research and development that is conducted in partnership between the academe and the industry will lead to higher chances of technology adoption. Business consultancy ensures that real-world problems are being addressed. Human resource development will guarantee that there will be sufficient supply of highly skilled technical people as the demand for them increases with technology adoption. Higher technology adoption will encourage more research and development, and the upward cycle continues. AMERIAL has partnered with the DOST-STII regional offices under the Small Enterprise Technology Upgrading Program, or Setup 4.0. We are thankful to USEC Sancho Baboran, Director Armand Ganal, and the other DOST-STII regional directors for being with us in partnering AMERIAL with MSMEs through Setup 4.0. It used to be that high technology and industrial automation were for the manufacturing giants only. With AMERIAL, the micro, small, and medium enterprises may now be able to access these technologies and enjoy their benefits. I'd like to take this opportunity to invite other MSMEs to avail of the services of AMERIAL for possible automation of your processes and facility upgrade. The DOST-STII puts great faith in the AMERIAL. We support it 100%. Congratulations on the successful establishment and future operations, cooperations, and collaborations with AMERIAL. Magandang adhan po sa ating lahat.
Thank you very much, Undersecretary Guevara. We are honored to have the support of your office in the AMERIAL's future endeavors in research and development. And now, may we hear from Engineer Sancho A. Maborang.
Thank you, Von and Maybelline, to our beloved Secretary Fortunato T. De La Peña, Undersecretary Rowena Cristina Guevara, MIRDC Executive Director, Engineer Robert Dizon, Fishard Executive Director, Dr. Enrico Pariñit, Mechatronics and Robotics Society of the Philippines, National President, Engineer Marichelle Choganco, Academia General Manager, Mr. Dave V. Molina, Hi-Tech Power Inc., President Engineer Eric Jude Suliman, DOST Regional Director Dr. Armando Ganal, Dr. Nancy A. Bantog, the Director of CAR, Dr. JC or Julius Cesar Sicat, Regional Director of DOST 3, Director Alfonso P. Alamban, the Regional Director of DOST 10, other Regional Directors present, Provincial Science and Technology Directors, my DOST family, friends, ladies and gentlemen, isang makaagham na umaga po sa ating lahat. First, allow me to congratulate the DOST MIRDC for the inauguration and launching of its Advanced Mechatronics, Robotics, and Industrial Automation Laboratory, or AMERIAL. Just in time, in the celebration of the 2021 Metals and Engineering or M&E Week. The theme of this week's celebration, the metals and engineering industries rising above challenges of the times, echoes what is stated in Proclamation Number 144, Series of 2011, which declared the period of June 13 to 18 of each year as the M&E Week. Indeed, the metals and engineering industries play a vital and significant role in the country's economic growth and development, being an indispensable part in government and private infrastructure projects. With the advent of the fourth industrial revolution, we see the ever-growing importance of these industries. Thus, in recognition of this, the Department of Science and Technology implements programs and establishes facilities that are envisioned to provide the needed scientific and technological interventions to those in the M&E industries. I can remember that when MIRD's Executive Director Dison presented the AMERIAL projects in one of the RD's meetings a few years ago, we at the regional operations got excited because we recognized right then and there the impacts that the project may have on our local small or medium enterprises. Hence, without hesitation, the DOST regional offices partnered with the MIRDC to implement the AMERIAL project. It is envisioned that through the AMERIAL project, we will be able to support the technological advancement, workforce improvement, and competitiveness of the MSMEs in the M&E sector. We are positive that the AMERIAL as a training and innovation hub can assist and encourage our MSMEs to venture into automation and adopt new technologies that will radically improve their operations. Ultimately, we hope to help these MSMEs through the AMERIAL project to transition to Industry 4.0. I am happy to share that the AMERIAL project team already started to assist MSMEs in the regions with the initial upgrading of their equipment and other electromechanical systems so that eventually through the years they can progress and migrate to automation, mechatronics, and robotics technologies, and ultimately be at the forefront of Industry 4.0. The AMERIAL project team has also conducted on-site visits to assess the firms, all of which were assisted under the DOST Small Enterprise Technology Upgrading Program or setup, starting with those that showed potential to adopt the automation in their operations. As an output of the visit, the team prepared recommendations on the automation process using the equipment that can analyze and diagnose issues without human involvement and will remove inefficiencies at all levels for much smoother operations. Technical details on the automation process and costing of technology are also included in the report. Through the AMERIAL setup collaboration and synergy, a total of 50 setup assisted firms from 9 regions were assessed since 2019. 4 firms from NCR, 5 from CAR, 17 from Region 1, 4 from Region 2, 5 from Region 3, 1 from Calabarzon, 10 from Region 6, 2 from Region 7, and 2 firms from Region 11. I am happy to announce that some of these assessed firms already expressed willingness to adopt and implement the recommendations, especially those interventions for mechanization and automation. This year, the AMERIAL project or the AMERIAL project team will continue to assess indoor setup assisted MSMEs in identified regions and conduct capability building activities for personnel from the different DOST regional offices so that they can also do assessment on their own. To the AMERIAL project team, thank you for the opportunity to work closely with you on this very important undertaking. Rest assured of our continuing support to all of your future endeavors. We are very much excited to work more closely with you as we continue to prepare and or transition our MSMEs in Industry 4.0. Once again, congratulations to the MIRDC, especially to the AMERIAL project team. Happy MNE Week and Mabuhay. Stay safe, everyone.
So now, to officially wrap things up, may we call on our Deputy Executive Director for Research and Development, Dr. Agustin M. Fodolig, to give his parting words to all of us.
Good morning, everyone. Before we end this morning's program, I would like to thank our keynote speaker, Secretary Fortunato T. De La Peña, for his motivational speech. Our very own Executive Director, Robert Audizon, for the very informative background of the project. Executive Director Enrico Paringet and MRSP President Maricel Tioganco for coming over for the ribbon cutting. DOST-1 Regional Director Armando Galal, our high-tech president, Mr. Eric Suliman, Academia General Manager, Mr. Dave Molina, and DOST Undersecretary for R&D, Rowena Cristina L. Guevara, and of course, Undersecretary for Regional Operations of DOST, Engineer Sancho Maborang. We thank them for the messages of support, and to all our guests online for joining us in this memorable occasion. Of course, I also would like to thank everyone who are behind this inauguration activity, the project team, MIRDC TDD Group, and our friends from the DOST-STII for making this event possible. I would like to commend the project leader, the project staff, DOST, Fishard, and everyone behind AMERIAL for the initiative to establish the facility that will serve as a training and innovation hub for advanced mechatronics, robotics, and industrial automation. Even with the current difficult situation, the team's effort to help the industry is remarkable. During the opening address, and also as explained during the overview, we heard that this project is one of the first steps in jumpstarting the Philippines towards Industry 4.0. We are excited to see that AMERIAL can bring to the M&E industry. As we open this new facility to everyone, we are looking forward to seeing its beneficiaries and clients with an improved background in automation, mechatronics, and robotics. On another note, I would like to invite everyone to join and celebrate the M&E Week. The MIRDC has prepared several activities and webinars for the week. We will be having webinars on programmable logic controls and industrial automation this afternoon. We hope to see you there. Stay healthy and safe. Thank you and congratulations, AMERIAL.
Thank you, Dr. Fodolig. And that's it, everyone. Thank you all for sharing your valuable time in attending the launching and inauguration of the AMERIAL. And also, I would also like to take this as an opportunity to thank Secretary Fortunato De La Peña, Director Paringet Apishert, Director Bob Dizon, MRSP National President, Engineer Tioganco, to our team from STII, thank you very much for accompanying us in this special event.
To the representatives of Hi-Tech Philippines, thank you very much. And to my fellow project team members, thank you very much. And we would also like to invite everyone to the upcoming webinars this afternoon. The webinars are about the introduction to PLC programming and introduction to Automation Studio software.
All of you, good luck and always stay safe. Again, this is Maybelline Rivera.
And I'm Bon Comedia.
Signing off.